advanced interrogation techniques, but to most people, it's just torture. Are you comfortable saying that that's okay?
Well, first of all, people who say it's torture are speaking from a pinnacle of near-perfect ignorance. The techniques that were used were not torture. Waterboarding is not torture. There are more journalists like you who have been waterboarded to prove that waterboarding is torture than there are terrorists who've been waterboarded.
So you think it's just not that bad?
Well, no, it's unpleasant, but it's incredibly effective.
So why is it not torture then?
Because it doesn't cause the kind of severe physical, mental pain suffering that torture does. It's not even comparable to those things that I just described to you. I mean, journalists do it to themselves all the time. Christopher Hitchens, who was a speaker here at the Festival of Dangerous Ideas a few years ago, underwent waterboarding to prove that it was torture. He was so unhappy with how poorly he did, he asked to try it again. Have you ever met a torture victim who asked to be tortured a second time?
There's a big difference between someone like a journalist or Christopher Hitchens doing this and knowing that they can say stop at any moment, and someone that thinks that they might die.
They don't think they're going to die because they're told that they're not going to die when they underwent it. There was no point in which they thought they were going to die.
But if you pull someone's fingernails out, they might not think they're going to die, but it's still unpleasant and it's still torture.
Pulling someone's fingernails, or would you try pulling some of your fingernails out to see how it felt?
No, but I also wouldn't try waterboarding.
Well, but a lot of people have. I mean, my point is that people try this to see what it feels like. They don't try pulling off their fingernails or burning themselves with hot irons and the rest. There's a qualitative difference between the two.
You still seem convinced that these techniques are right, that they should be used. Should the scheme, do you think, be brought back?
Absolutely. I mean, we can't be safe without this kind of interrogation program. I mean, it's not even that we're not using enhanced interrogation anymore. We're not capturing, detaining, and interrogating the United States high-value terrorists anymore. We are still dining out on the intelligence that was gleaned from KSM and those other detainees. I mean, the interrogation program stopped 2.5 years ago, but the most important operation under the Obama administration was a direct result of intelligence that was provided by those detainees, the killing of bin Laden.